Good afternoon, dear students. Here we are going to discuss biochips and concept of DNA microarray. Yeah, what is a DNA microarray? What is a biochip or a DNA chip, also called as a gene chip, that we are going to discuss in brief. Okay. Now, what is a microarray? Especially, what is a DNA microarray or what is a gene chip? The ordered arrangement of large number of DNA probes on a solid surface made up of silicon or nylon or glass is called as gene chip or microarray. So what is a microarray? DNA microarray, ordered arrangement of large number of DNA probes on a definite surface or a definite marked area. Okay, so ordered arrangement of large number of DNA probes on a solid surface made of silicon or nylon is called as a gene chip or a microarray. Now, a particular series of small spots of DNA probe, okay, a particular series of small spots of DNA probe are fixed on a solid surface to detect and screen mRNAs and genomic DNAs in the samples. Okay, so why the DNA probe, small spot of DNA probes are fixed on a solid surface to detect and screen mRNA and genomic DNA present in the sample is called as DNA microarray or a DNA chip or a gene chip. Now, each DNA spot contains 10^-12 moles of DNA probe. The probe is a short DNA molecule, such as a complementary DNA or a synthetic oligonucleotide. Each DNA probe immobilized in a microarray has a different sequence. Now, because each DNA probe immobilized on a microarray has a different sequence, you can analyze so many number of samples at a time. Okay, DNA chip or the gene chip contains thousands of DNA probes. Okay, 64,000 or more, it is said. A DNA chip or a gene chip contains thousands of DNA probes immobilized on a small glass plate in 1 square centimeter area. And hence, a DNA microarray or a chip can be used to detect thousands of different genes or diseases at a time from the small volume of sample. And one more important thing, after washing, the microarray or the chip can be reused for analyzing other samples. Okay? So you can look at the photo of a glass slide of DNA microarray. Now they are not so big also, they are very small now. So a microarray, you can see small dots, okay, small spots of DNA probe. These are, every spot has a DNA probe in it, okay. Thousands of probes, very small quantity, say 10^-12 is the quantity of DNA. 10^-12 moles DNA probe is present in each spot, right? What one spot consists of? One spot consists of a chemical matrix that is fixed on the plate. Okay, that is the solid plate with chemical matrix to which it's attached the DNA probe. The DNA probe is attached to the chemical matrix. And the DNA probe, each DNA probe has a different sequence and can be used to analyze different DNA or mRNA present in the sample. How do you prepare the microarray? First, you take a glass plate. The glass plate or the nylon plate, whatever the plate you want to take, is coated with a binding substance. Okay, so that the DNA probe binds to it. Okay, so that the DNA probe can be attached to it. So at first, the glass plate is coated with a binding substance, and then each oligonucleotide, that is the DNA probe, is fixed on the plate one by one using a robot. Okay, so a robot is used to fix DNA probe one by one on the glass plate. Okay, but first, the plate has to be coated with a binding substance. Now the DNA, the probe DNA that are used to make the microarray are obtained from open reading frames of the genome. They are amplified by PCR technique. The duplex DNA is denatured into single strands by alkali treatment, and then the single-stranded DNA are used as DNA probe. First, the glass plate or the membrane is coated with a chemical matrix, which is nothing but the binding substance. Okay, so first the glass plate or nylon membrane or whatever membrane you are using is coated with a chemical matrix, and using chemicals like polylysine or epoxysilane or aminosilane or polyacrylamide. This process is called as fabrication. Okay, So using a chemical matrix like polylysine or epoxysilane or aminosilane or polyacrylamide, we coat the membrane first, okay, to make, this coating is called as fabrication, so that the DNA probe can be fixed. The chemical matrix provides free reactive group, okay, and with the help of this free reactive group, covalent bonds can be formed with DNA probes, and that is how you attach one DNA probe at one spot, at one point. Okay, so first take the plate, okay, coat it with the chemical matrix. The chemical matrix has free reactive group for establishing covalent bond with DNA. The DNA probe are then spotted as small dots on the solid surface with the help of a robot. The robot has an arm which we call as microarrayer. Okay, and coating with the DNA probe, okay, and then you can say exposing the plate to light and finally getting the finished plate is called as photolithography. The slide such prepared is called as a microarray, and because we have spotted DNA, we will call it DNA microarray. Each of the oligonucleotide, that is DNA probe, is so modified that it contains photolabile protecting group. It has a photolabile protecting group. The gene chip or microarray is exposed to light for activation. Okay, it has to be exposed to light for activation. If it is not activated, then the exogenous DNA, that is the DNA present in the sample, which is going to come from outside. The exogenous DNA in sample solution does not react with oligonucleotides spotted on the DNA microarray if they are not activated by light. So the gene chip or the microarray has to be activated by exposing it to light. Once you have your gene chip or DNA microarray is ready, then you have to perform target analysis or sample analysis. Okay, so you have a target DNA or sample DNA or RNA. So this target DNA or RNA is first isolated from the suspected material or from the sample. So if you're given a sample, you have to isolate the target DNA or RNA. And then the target DNA or whatever it are, the RNA is cut with a restriction enzyme and amplified by PCR in vitro, okay? So the target DNA is first isolated from the suspected material or sample. It is cut into pieces with the help of restriction enzyme and amplified by PCR in vitro. The DNA fragments are then labeled with fluorescent compound, okay, called as fluorophore, okay? So every DNA fragment is labeled with fluorescent compound or fluorophore. Now, you have to take the gene chip, and then the gene chip is dipped in the fluorescent label sample DNA solution for hybridization. Okay, so you have a fluorescent compound labeled sample DNA solution. Okay, in that solution, you dip the DNA gene chip or DNA microarray and allow the hybridization to take place. Allow incubated. Okay, after incubation, remove the chip. Remove the chip, take out the chip from the sample solution. Wash the chip, okay, and to remove the unbound samples and all. Okay, so after washing, the chip is exposed to laser beam, right? So you remove the chip, wash it, then the chip is exposed to, or the microarray is exposed to laser beam in order to excite the fluorescent compound. See, the fluorescent compound is present only along with the DNA fragment in the sample. Okay, only the sample DNA fragment is labeled with fluorescent compound. Okay, and if your sample DNA hybridizes with the DNA probe present on the gene chip, and then at that particular point, hybridization will be there between the, if they are complementary, if the DNA present on the gene chip DNA probe is complementary to the DNA in the sample, they will undergo hybridization. And the point where DNA or hybrid is formed, at that point only the fluorescent compound will be present. Rest of the unbound DNA are washed. So after washing, the chip is exposed to laser beam so that the fluorescent compound is activated. Okay, so excited. So wherever there is fluorescent compound, there will be excitation and you will get fluorescence. So the dot of microarray or the dot on the gene chip, what is this dot? This is a DNA probe. The dot is nothing but a DNA probe. So the dot of microarray that is hybridized with the labeled DNA of the sample fluoresces either green or red depending upon the fluorescent dye that you have used. Okay, so the dot of the microarray or the point wherever there is hybridization between the DNA probe and the labeled sample DNA, green or red fluorescent light will be seen. Okay, the monochromatic light emitted from the hybridized array unit is received by the detector immediately. As soon as light is emitted, it is received by the detector, which converts the light ray into a scanning image. Okay, now when this image is fed into the computer installed with the processing software, the computer will give you a detail of hybridized DNA or the pathogenic gene that is detected, the pathogens associated with it, genetic disorders, if anything you want to know will be, the result will give you. Okay, so whatever monochromatic light is emitted from the hybridized array received by the detector, detector converts it into a scanning image. As soon as you feed the scanning image to the computer software will give you a detailed information about what was the sample DNA that hybridized with the dot on the microarray, what are the pathogenic genes present, what is the pathogen associated, if there is any genetic disorder, everything in every information you will get. So this is the diagrammatic representation. This is a gene chip having all microarray. It is exposed to light for activation and you have an activated chip ready. Now you have a suspected tissue, a suspected patient sample. You isolate the DNA and cut it into fragments by restriction digestion. And then each DNA fragment is coupled with a fluorophore, that is fluorescent compound. Sometimes you need to amplify the DNA also. So the DNA fragments are coated with fluorophore. Now the chip is put into the solution of DNA fragment coated with fluorescent compound and allowed to undergo hybridization. Then you remove the gene chip. So the gene chip is present now with hybridized DNA. You wash it. Okay. After washing, you have to expose it to laser beam. So laser beam, and we have shown here black spots where hybridization has taken place. As soon as laser beam strikes the gene chip, the point where there is hybridization, there is fluorescent compound present, and that fluorescent compound will excite, and fluorescence immediately, the fluorescence or the light, excited light is captured by the fluorescence detector, and a scanned image is obtained, which is fed into the computer, and you get the every detailed information about the hybridized DNA. That is how gene chip is used for diagnosis or analyzing or identifying a specific DNA or RNA present in the sample. What is the application? Gene chips have been extensively used for diagnosis of several pathogenic and genetic diseases in man, like asthma or rheumatoid arthritis or atherosclerosis or so many other genetic diseases also. We can also, detection of cancers or diabetes and all. Okay, DNA microarray is employed in genotyping of, okay, through single nucleotide polymorphism. Okay. Then we can use specific probes. Using specific probes, DNA microarray is used to identify microbes present in the organism. We can also identify pathogenic microorganisms present in the patient sample. Microarray is used in the analysis of transcriptomes and proteomes. Okay. DNA microarray is used to detect gene and gene expression also by analyzing the complementary DNA produced from mRNA of a cell type at different times. By using microarray, thousands of diseases or complementary strands can be detected at a time. Okay, at a time, so many samples can be analyzed. That is the best advantage. And the one more advantage is after washing, the microarray chip can be reused for further studies. Okay, so that is all about concept of DNA microarray or gene chip or DNA